Good afternoon to all of you. Welcome to Food Safety Webinar conducted by Faculty of Food Safety, IGMPI India. Our today's topic on food safety is focused on WHO's Food Safe 5 Keys. So now let's start with food safety. What is food safety? In simpler terms, food safety is about handling, storing, and preparing food to prevent infection and help to make sure that our food keeps enough nutrients for us to have a healthy diet. Unsafe food and water means that it has been exposed to dirt and germs or may even be rotten, which can cause infections or diseases such as diarrhea, meningitis, etc. Now, why this food safety is important? As per WHO, the great majority of people will experience a foodborne disease at some point in their lives. This highlights the importance of making sure the food we eat is not contaminated with potentially harmful bacteria, parasites, viruses, toxins, and chemicals. Like if we are consuming the food which is contaminated with these bacteria, parasites, viruses, then what will happen? We will fall ill and we will not be able to go to college. We will not be able to do our work. We will not be able to go to our workplace. So that is why food safety is very important aspect in our life. So now what are major foodborne illnesses and their causes? Foodborne illnesses are usually infectious or toxic in nature and are caused by the bacteria, viruses, parasites, or chemical substances entering the body through contaminated food or water. So foodborne pathogens can cause severe diarrhea, which is also known as food poisoning. Chemical contamination can lead to acute poisoning, or it can also lead to long-term disease such as cancer, like the chemicals such as preservatives also, they are all carcinogenic in nature. And if they are added in excess in the product, they can cause the long-term diseases. And foodborne diseases may lead to long-lasting disability and death also. Examples of unsafe food include uncooked foods of animal origin, fruits and vegetables contaminated with feces, and raw shellfish containing marine biotoxins. Now, evolving world and food safety. The world is evolving, and that's why we need food safety. The proportion of the population who have increased susceptibility to foodborne illness is increasing day by day. For example, the elderly community in many parts of the world, including Japan and many other Western countries, is increasing day by day. So thereby, the number of immunocompromised consumers are also increasing. Next is changing lifestyle have resulted in a number of changes to our eating habits. More people now regularly eat out or snack on the move, which has led to an increased demand for food safety, service establishment of varying standards. Many people work outside the home and rely on processed food for fast meal preparation. This has meant that knowledge of how to handle and prepare foods has decreased in recent years. Increased tourism has meant that people are exposed to foodborne hazards from other areas as well. Now, and global sourcing of finished product. Now, let us take an example. If you are having a product, chicken cake from the market. So you will see this product is composed of mainly herb, butter, chicken breast, batter, and breadcrumb. But the ingredients for this product are from all over the world. Say, salted butter is from Ireland, garlic butter is from China, and garlic salt is from China, lemon is from USA, parsley is from France. So you see all the countries are, so you can see there are so many countries which are involved in making of this product. So that is why the food safety is important for whole world. So who can contribute to making food safe? One is policy makers, like FSSAI in India, FDA in US. So they can build and maintain adequate food systems and infrastructures to respond to and manage food safety risk along the entire food chain, including during emergencies. They can foster multi-sectoral collaboration among public health, animal health, agriculture, and other sectors for better communication and joint action. They can integrate food safety into broader food policies and programs, nutrition and food security. They need to think globally and act locally to ensure the food produced domestically is safe internationally. Now next is food handlers and consumers. So consumers, they need to read the labels on the food package. By reading the label, they will get to know like what is there in the product, and then they can make the informed choices, and they can also become familiar with the common food hazards associated with that food. Next is the food handlers need to handle and prepare food safely by practicing the WHO 5 keys to safer food at home or when selling at restaurants or at local markets. So now what are these WHO 5 keys? Let's see. WHO 5 keys are, first key says keep clean, second key says separate raw and cooked food, third is about cook food thoroughly, fourth is about keep food at safe temperatures, fifth is about use safe water and raw materials. So key one is keep clean. So what we need to keep clean? We need to keep all the food contact surfaces clean. Food contact surfaces means hands, the desk, the utensils, all these knives, chopping boards, we need to keep them clean. So wash your hands before handling food and often during food preparation. Wash your hands after going to toilet. Wash and sanitize all food contact surfaces and equipment used for food preparation. Protect kitchen areas and food from insect, pest and other animals. Next is, why do we need to keep all the things clean? While most organisms do not cause disease, dangerous microorganisms are widely found in soil, water, animals and people. These microorganisms are carried on hands, wiping cloths and utensils, especially cutting boards, and the slightest contact can transfer them to the food and can cause foodborne diseases. So now what is the correct procedure for hand washing? So for hand washing, there are 6 basic steps. First step is wet your hands with warm running water. Second step is apply soap. Third step is rub hands for 20 seconds. Now, so as to ensure the 20 seconds duration, what you can do, you can sing the jingle Happy Birthday to you twice. So when you sing it twice, it will take approximately 20 seconds. Fourth is rinse hands thoroughly with the water. Fifth is dry hands with the paper towel, and it should be single use towel. That is like you are wiping your hands, you are drying your hands, and then you are throwing it off. Sixth is turn off the tap with the paper towel if it is a hand operated tap. Otherwise, if it is a knee operated tap and if it is a foot operated tap, you need not to touch it again. So next is, when do we need to wash our hands? First is before, during and after preparing food. Before eating food, before and after caring for someone who is sick, before and after treating a cut or wound, after using the toilet, after changing diapers or cleaning up a child who has used the toilet, after blowing your nose, coughing or sneezing, after touching an animal, animal feed or animal waste, after handling pet food or pet treats, after touching garbage, because all these things can contaminate your hand. So after doing all these things or touching these things, you need to wash your hands. So next is key two. Key two is about separate raw and cooked food so as to avoid cross contamination. So now what is cross contamination? Cross contamination is the spread of contaminant or spread of microorganism or transfer of microorganism from the dirty product to clean product, from the safe product, from the unsafe product to safe product. So this is cross contamination. So separate raw meat, poultry and seafood from other foods. Use separate equipment and utensils such as knives and cutting boards for handling raw foods. Store food in containers to avoid contact between raw and prepared foods. So why do we need to do this separate, keep separate these things? Raw food, especially meat, poultry and seafood and their juices can contain dangerous microorganisms which may be transferred onto other foods during food preparation and storage. So that is why we need to keep these things separate. So when do we need to practice this separation? First is when shopping. Separate raw meat, poultry and seafood from other foods in your grocery shopping cart. Place these foods in plastic bags to prevent their juices from dripping onto the other foods. It is also best to separate these foods from other foods at the checkout and in your grocery bags. When refrigerating food, place raw meat, poultry and seafood in containers or sealed plastic bags to prevent their juices from dripping onto other foods. Raw juices often contain harmful bacteria. Store eggs in their original carton and refrigerate as soon as possible. When preparing food at home or in the industry, wash hands and surfaces often. Harmful bacteria can spread throughout the kitchen and get onto cutting boards, utensils and countertops. So you need to wash your hands while working. Like while after touching the dirty things, you need to wash your hands so as to avoid the cross-contamination, transfer of bacteria from unclean product to clean product. Next is when serving food, always use a clean plate. Never place cooked food back on the same plate or cutting board that was previously used for raw product. When storing leftovers, refrigerate or freeze leftovers within 2 hours or sooner in clean, shallow and cool place so as to prevent harmful bacteria from multiplying. Food storage order, like what should be the food storage order in your fridge? So first is like on the top shelf you need to store ready to eat foods. Then you need to store raw seafood. Next is raw whole meat should be stored. Then raw ground meat should be stored. And at the bottom of your refrigerator, you need to store raw poultry products because this is the high-risk product. So the top shelf should, in the top shelf, the ready-to-eat products should be stored, which are not to be cooked before consumption. And vegetables should be cooked to a temperature of 135 degree Fahrenheit before consumption. Seafood, fish, eggs, they should be cooked to a minimum cooking temperature of 145 degree Fahrenheit. Raw whole meats should be cooked to a minimum cooking temperature of 145 degree Fahrenheit. Raw ground meat should be cooked to a minimum temperature of 155 degree Fahrenheit. Raw poultry minimum cooking temperature should be 165 degree Fahrenheit. So these products should be cooked to these temperatures so as to make them safe. Next is key 3, cook thoroughly. So why the product should be cooked thoroughly? Cook food thoroughly, especially meat, poultry, eggs and seafood because these are high risk products. Bring foods like soups and stews to boiling to make sure that they have reached 70 degrees Celsius temperature. For meat and poultry, make sure juices are clear, not pink, and ideally use thermometer for checking the product internal temperature. Reheat cooked food thoroughly before consumption. Why we need to do all these things? Because proper cooking can kill almost all dangerous microorganisms. Studies have shown that cooking food to a temperature of 70 degrees Celsius can help ensure it is safe for consumption. Foods that require special attention include minced meats, rolled oats, large joints of meat and whole poultry. So these are all high risk products. So now what is temperature danger zone? The temperature zone between 5 degrees Celsius to 60 degrees Celsius is termed as temperature danger zone. So this is called temperature danger zone because this is the zone where bacteria can grow and multiply easily. So this is the favorable temperature for bacterial growth and multiplication. So if high risk foods have been left in the temperature zone for up to 2 hours, and the food should be reheated, refrigerated or consumed. If the high foods have been left in the temperature danger zone for longer than 2 hours but less than 4 hours, they should be consumed immediately. They should not be stored, but they need to be consumed. And like if it is kept for more than 4 hours outside, then it should be, then the product should be thrown away. It should not be used. It should not be consumed. It should be discarded so as to avoid the food safety problem. And all the food should be cooked to a temperature of 75 degrees Celsius temperature. Next is key 4. Key 4 is like keep food at safe temperatures. Do not leave cooked food at room temperature for more than 2 hours as we have seen in the earlier slide. Refrigerate promptly all cooked and perishable food, preferably below 5 degrees Celsius. Keep cooked food piping hot prior to serving. Like if you are serving the product which has been cooked prior, then you need to reheat it to 60 degrees Celsius temperature, minimum 60. Do not store food too long even in the refrigerator. Do not thaw frozen food at room temperature. The frozen food should be thawed under cold running water, or it should be kept at refrigeration temperature for thawing so as to avoid the microbiological contamination and multiplication. So microorganisms can multiply very quickly if food is stored at room temperature, because that is a danger zone. So by holding a temperature below 5 degrees Celsius or above 60 degrees Celsius, the growth of microorganisms is slowed down or stopped. Some dangerous microorganisms still grow below 5 degrees Celsius temperature. Next is use safe water and raw materials. So use safe water or treat it to make safe. Like as per Indian standard, the water, the potable water should comply with IS 10500 regulations. Select fresh and wholesome foods. Choose foods processed for safety, such as pasteurized milk. Wash fruits and vegetables, especially if eaten raw. Do not use food beyond its expiry date. Why? Because raw materials including water and ice may be contaminated with dangerous microorganisms and chemicals. Toxic chemicals may be formed in damaged and moldy foods. Care in selection of raw materials and simple measures such as washing and peeling may reduce the risk, because washing and peeling, they can reduce the microbiological risk, or they can also help in reducing the other contamination from the product. So for more information on food safety and other food related topics, you can enroll in our food safety programs. So the food safety programs we are offering are for diploma and executive courses. We are offering food analysis and quality assurance program, food and agribusiness management program, food quality assurance and quality control specially designed for food industry professionals, food processing and preservation. This program covers all the processing and preservation techniques, good laboratory practices, good manufacturing practices, food regulatory affairs program is there, food safety, food product management, food sales and marketing management, nutrition and dietetics program is there, nutraceuticals program is there, probiotics in food, organic farming and food production system, this is a novel program, GAP certification, food safety in hospitality industries, food supply chain program, food packaging programs are there, bakery and confectionery, bakery science and technology. You can also enroll for dairy science and technology. We are also offering certified FSMS lead auditor course, diploma in food processing, hospitality and hotel management. Our professional certification courses include FSSAI Food Safety Supervisor course, Certified Food GMP Professional course, Certified Food Quality Manager, Certified Food Quality Auditor, Certified HACCP Auditor Course, Certified Regulatory Affairs Professional Courses, Certified Food Quality Technician, Certified Validation Professional Course, Certified Quality Risk Management Professional Course, Certified FSMS Lead Auditor Course, and Certified FSMS Lead Auditor Course. We are also offering industry certificate programs in HACCP, GAP certification, clinical nutrition certification, and food safety management system program. Our short-term courses include analytical instrumentation for food analysis, analytical approaches to food safety issues, approaches to proximate analysis of food, sensory analysis in quality control, bakery, and probiotics. We are also offering management programs in 2-year PGD in nutrition and dietetics and MSc in food and nutrition, 2 years postgraduate diploma in hospitality and hotel management, and MBA in hotel management, 2 years postgraduate diploma in food and agribusiness management along with MBA in agricultural management, 2 years PGD in dairy science and technology along with MBA in dairy management, 2 years PGD in good manufacturing practices along with MBA in production management. For more information about our courses, you can contact our executive officer, Ms. Lalita Kumari, at 0120-4375-280 and 81309-24488. You can also mail us at info@igmpiindia.org. Thank you for joining our webinar.